All right, David Harry here. Now, are you a person who's thinking about buying a GoPro Hero 9 Black, or are you a person who's thinking of going to a GoPro Hero 9 Black from a Hero 8, or maybe one of the earlier Heroes? If so, I would suggest you watch as much of this video as possible, but definitely join me at the end for the summary, because this video, you won't find out exactly what went on in it until the end, because I'm doing this as a blind A-B thing. I'll explain all this as I go through. I'm not going to go up front here with a ton of technical nonsense, because I do all that in the video. Anyways, let's get into the video. Watch as much of it as you possibly can. It is quite long. There will be chapter markers to help you skip through to poignant points of the video or the start of different sections. I don't have meaningful titles in the description below to the chapters. It's just going to be chapter 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. And also in the actual timeline on the player on YouTube, you'll see those marked up chapters. Just skip through them, enjoy as many of them as you possibly can. But definitely get to the end and join me in the summary of the video. Now, just before I get into this, all my videos to do with all my Hero stuff can be got at by going to www.gopro9.com. Also, all the stuff that I use with me, like Hero rigs and my Hero setups, there's always links to all that stuff in the descriptions to the videos to do with my Hero stuff. Anyways, watch as much of this video as you possibly can and join me at the end in the summary. Okay, so just to be clear here, this is a blind A-B test, which means that what I'm going to do is alternate from one camera to the other until I get to the end of the video. Once I get to the end of the video, I will then just say which one, A or B, was which camera. Now, it is unlikely that I'm going to be able to synchronize myself properly between the cuts when going from camera to camera, so this might all be a little bit random where I'm looking and stuff, but what we are interested in here is basically just what picture I'm actually flipping to, whether I'm staring at the camera or not. Now, just to make things even more clearer here, resolutions are 4K for the Hero 8, 5K for the Hero 9. However, in post-production, I will be editing in 5K and uploading in 5K. So nonetheless, both cameras will end up being 5K. Right, lens mode is linear for both cameras. Also, bitrate is set to high for both cameras. Shutter is on auto for both cameras. EV comp is on zero for both cameras. White balance is on auto for both cameras. ISO minimum 100 for both cameras. ISO maximum 1600 for both cameras. Sharpness set to high for both cameras. And both cameras are in the devil's preferred color, which is GoPro color. Right, so what I'm going to do, I'm just going to start trolleying off. I'll do a bunch of things, cutting between these things. Like I say, I may not look at the camera at the right time when I do the cut, but A or B is what you'll be looking at, and you'll be able to kind of like define for yourself as to whether or not there's enough differences in there between them to warrant the upgrade from one to the other, well, from the 8 to the 9. Also, it'd be interesting just to see if people actually get this correct before the end. And if they do get it correct, do they actually think that the 9 is much better anyways? So as you could see there, those settings that I've used, this is really confusing. I don't know which one to look at. I may not look into the camera. I know that's a little bit rude. I might just have to look ahead of me because it's confusing. Oops, I just swore then. Okay, so I've cut that out. Anyways, yeah, I'm going to be cutting A and B and let's see what's going on. But also as well, the thing to note here is the settings that I'm using are effectively the most bog standard out of the box settings that most people would be likely to use. So this is definitely going to give us a really good indication of exactly how different or not these things are when they are set to the same settings as possible, or as best as possible. Obviously, resolution's a bit different, and also setting it in such a way that it's representative of how the vast majority of people would use these cameras. Okay, now another thing to bear in mind here as well, I'm using the microphones off just one camera. Now, I'm not going to tell you which mic it is that I'm using, and the reason for that is because I don't want people to be able to guess from the mic sound which camera it is. Also as well, this microphone has got a little tiny dead cat on it just to give it the best possible opportunity that I can for, like, you know, basically picking up the sound without any wind distortion and stuff like that. But at the end, I will tell you which one it was that I was using for the internal microphone. Now, on the point of the internal microphones for both of these cameras, I will at some point be doing a test comparing both of the internal microphones as well. Like I say, I didn't want this like video to kind of go into that territory, because it is something that I do want to do as a separate thing and just concentrate on that alone in one video. Also, on the point of microphones as well, what I'm going to do as far as the Hero 9 is concerned, I'm going to be doing tests between its internal microphone and also the microphone off its media mod as well, just so we can get a really good idea as to what that's all about. So what we're looking at now then is the sun directly behind me, but both of the cameras are falling within my shadow, so therefore the sun isn't going straight into the lenses either. So what we're getting here is the cameras in shadow and seeing how they deal with me. Now, if I lift up like this, what we have now got is the sun still directly behind me, but now the sun is going straight into the lenses of both of the cameras here. So this is going to give us another idea of a certain type of exposure on me. Now, don't forget, this is all completely out of the box and completely automatic for the best part. So there's been like no touching the screen for doing any kind of like, you know, assist with exposure or anything like that. Okay, so this little bit here should give us a really good idea of what's going to happen going in and out of direct sunlight. Now what I'm going to do is do some turning, and I'll explain what's going on as I do that. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is turn around as slowly as I can to try and be as steady as I can, and once again just kind of chop between both of the cameras. Now what we're going to have to bear in mind here is that at some point we are going to hit direct sunlight once again. Let's see how both cameras handle that and what they do with it. So right now, I'm right now into the sun. So that should give us an idea of what's going on there with that. Then I'll just carry on turning round. Now, like I say, I'm going to have to cut these to make some sense between the pair of them. Then I'll also be doing those little side-by-side things with it as well. Now, again, I don't know where the cuts are going to occur or anything like that, but hopefully I'm going slow enough on this little turnaround here so that the actual cuts are kind of held long enough. See, if I were to turn around very fast here, the cuts wouldn't be able to hold long enough for any kind of particular exposure. So hopefully I'm not cutting too fast, because I don't know how fast I'm going to have to cut this. And hopefully it's not all too slow and boring either. Okay, so I think that's me done 360 degrees there. So that should give us a really good idea of that. Right, so I'm now in a massively shaded area underneath all these trees. So this is going to give us a really good idea as to how both of the cameras are going to be reacting when they are in their like automatic modes, but going into like pretty bad lighting conditions. Now, behind me, you may think that that all looks kind of okay and stuff, but that will be both of the cameras just gaining up massively in order to get whatever it is that they're getting there. Just seriously, I'm getting really confused looking between these two cameras. I really must just look away from them now. Yeah, so basically, as I turn around here, you know, we're going to be seeing what looks like well exposed, maybe noisy, obviously, because it is gaining up. But seriously, where I am right now is definitely very, very shaded. And it is definitely not the type of place that you would want to bring a camera like these, only because it is just not that good for light right now. But it is going to give us a very good idea as to how both of the cameras are handling this scenario, which obviously we have to know in order to do so, you know, in order to basically gauge what the tests are all going to be like between whatever the cameras can and they can't do. Okay, now I don't know how this is going to work out. What it is, I'm just going into some really serious undergrowth and trees and weird foliage and stuff. So yeah, just bear with me on this one, because this is definitely going to push both of them. I'm going into even darker bits here, and it's also a bit rough and stuff. I've just had to go through a ton of brambles, and I've only got shorts on like a complete big moron. So again, I have to do these things so we can push and pull both of the cameras to see exactly what they can and they can't do, or more importantly, what they can and they can't do compared to one another. Because whatever one camera can do well is probably going to be the same for the other camera as well. And obviously, the stuff that one can't do so well is probably going to be the same for the other camera, but nonetheless we do need to test a few different scenarios where both cameras are being pushed and pulled to their limits. Not going through them friggin' brambles again. My legs are wrecked, right? So I think for the best part here, I've been going through some pretty, you know, pretty rough kind of like scenarios with the cameras, because like I say, they're not designed for this type of light. Although the actual, like, you know, the terrain and the foliage and stuff, they're definitely designed for all this because of the stabilization and what have you. But it'll be just very interesting to see how they both stack up or not, either A, independently with regard this type of scenario, or B, against one another. Okay, right, I need to get to somewhere sane right now, but I need to try and do it without going through brambles and all these bushes with like loads of spikes on and stuff. Yeah, that wasn't the way to go. That was going to be even worse. Okay, so I've just resisted the urge to act like a complete big fool and go through this massive patch of brambles over there and stuff and other assortments of spiky plants. So what I'm going to do now is get to somewhere saner. And then what I'll do, I've brought out this little tripod here, little cheap thing. I'll just throw the cameras on the tripod and I will switch off their stabilizers. And so what we'll see is what they're capable of recording like without the stabilizers on. Let's see if we get any kind of noticeable differences with that. Also as well, I'm not too sure if I'll have mentioned so far. I don't know if I missed it at the beginning. For stabilization, both of them are just on their highest setting before boost. On the Hero 8, it's obviously hyper smooth too, so I'm on high for that. And then on the Hero 9, that is hyper smooth 3, which is just set to like normal. Now in this instance, neither one of them are using their like boosted kind of full-on modes for their hyper smooth versions. And the reason why I'm not going to do that in this particular video, just like I'm not going to fool around with the mics, is because I'm going to do separate videos as well. One of them will be all about the stabilization, because there is no doubt that the Hero 9 has definitely upped the game on the stabilization. Whether we'll see it in this video just doing regular walkie stuff, I'm not too sure. Anyway, so what I'm going to do now, I've got a nice good bit of light here. I'm going to put the cameras on the tripod and I'll try something completely different. Now when I say something completely different, what I really meant to say there was something which is not that different, but just with the stabilizer switched off. Now hopefully what I can do here is cut from camera to camera as I'm talking, and hopefully it will make sense now as I'm looking at the cameras as to what I am cutting to. So hopefully what we should see here right now is a slightly wider field of view, although we may not notice that, and the reason why we may not notice it is only because, you know, you wouldn't really know what distance I'm maintaining from the cameras and stuff like that. However, hopefully what we might see is maybe a little bit more clarity, a bit more sharpness and stuff like that. But don't forget, for anything like clarity, sharpness, any type of way of kind of like judging the picture and stuff, you really have to be watching these at like proper high resolutions and on high resolution monitors. So as much as what maybe people don't have 5K plus monitors and stuff like that, which is understandable, if you have 4K, then I would strongly suggest that you'd have been watching this with the 5K stream, but in 4K. Okay, so hopefully that's going to be all good for that. What it is, there's people walking around the park looking at me as if I'm a big mad weirdo. I've got to be careful not to frighten the kids. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is pretty much do a similar thing and turn the camera set around. Actually, hold on, in fact, just before I do that, I'm going to do a split screen here. So right now, so what we're seeing here is a split screen between the two cameras. Now, as far as the Hero 9 is concerned, all I will have done in post is just moved it slightly horizontally somewhere just to make the split happen. Now, of course, with the Hero 8, what I've been doing here is expanding its pixels and stuff to match 5K. So Yeah, it's a little bit unfair on the 8 because we are manipulating the pixels, but we're not doing that with the 9. Anyways, nonetheless, what this should give us is a better idea of, like, you know, with the split screen as to what may or may not be the best between them and stuff like that. Really, I need to work out what I'm going to say before I do these takes, shouldn't I? Okay, so what I'm going to do now is turn the cameras around and I will point them into the sun and do something similar, but won't hang around on that one. Okay, so both cameras now pointing towards the sun here. Now, the only thing is, because I can't really see what's going on, I don't know how effective this is going to be, because I'm trying my best actually. Think both cameras are now falling within shadow, so that should give us an idea between both of the cameras how they're performing and picking me up now that I'm, well, now that the cameras are falling within my shadow. So hopefully as I'm doing this bit here, we're getting enough of a kind of difference in the alternating and the split. Sorry, some bug thing just went right past me there. I have to be careful actually in this park. 3 weeks ago I got bit by one of those things that give you Lyme disease, and my leg came up quite a bit around the bite and stuff like that. I don't think anything's happened, or at least if it has done, I don't appear to be any different. I'm still lazy and don't like getting out of bed. Anyway, so this is in my shadow. Now what I'm going to do here is come out of the shadow. I think I'm probably on the edge. I should be on the edge of the screen here, and then that sun is like, or like right in the faces of both of the GoPros there. So I'll just do a little bit more like this here, because that should give us just another idea of a something. I mean, I don't know how well either of these would expose with the sun going straight in when you're trying to get the person standing in front of them, if you're not trying to do any kind of touch the screen for any kind of manual focus and stuff anyway. Okay, all right, so what I'm gonna do is think of something else quickly to do here. Because once again, people are looking at me like I'm a big, mad, weird person. Actually, one thing I think I should do here, and that is absolute focus, actually. And so what I'm going to do here, I'm on full arm's length away. So hopefully, I'm going to be able to cut and kind of like, you know, put things side by side in such a way that the take doesn't go dead long, but we'll get a good idea of what it is that I'm trying to achieve here. Now, I've gotten closer again, so I'm not going to hazard a guess at the measurements here, but what we should be able to see is, as I do this, the relative differences between both of the cameras. In fact, if I was to hazard a guess, I'm about 12 inches away from both of the cameras, so this is extremely close. So what I'm going to try and do is kind of pad out me dialogue a little bit here, because we really do need to see when I'm holding on like the shots and maybe doing these splits as well. The only problem is I'm not entirely sure if I can get my face right in the middle on a split and stuff like that, but I think we'll defo get enough of a kind of, you know, taste here, because obviously I've got like loads of grey bits and stuff, and I'm like, you know, I've not had a shave, so hopefully this is all helping. Right, so I'll get a bit closer again. I think maybe I might be about, I don't know, about 8 inches away from both of the cameras here. Let me just, I don't even know where I am in the frame. What it is, one of these cameras has got a front front screen on it. The only problem is that bright, I can't see anything. Right, so that's how close I am there, about 8 inches away. Like I say, whether I'm off on the distances isn't a problem, because we're just trying to see for any relative differences between the two cameras. Now I'm gonna do, I'm trying to work out, I don't want to get into the shadow on the cameras here, but that's a lot closer. I mean, this is far too close. This is the kind of closeness where nothing to do with me is going to be in focus. Then what I'm going to do, in fact, you know what, I'll maintain a split here between the two of them, then I'll start slowly pulling away. Now, I can't tell you what these measurements are, but once again, what I'm doing here is pulling away slowly on a split screen. And hopefully there's enough of me on either side of the split here to give us an idea of, you know, what the differences are between both sides, so that we can see exactly which one looks maybe the best for close focus. I mean, they may both be exactly the same, and I sincerely hope so, because I've always been happy with the Heroes for that, and at this point here I'm definitely in focus on both of them. Okay, right, what I'm going to do now is shoot off indoors, have a little look at all this stuff, edit it up as best as possible. What you're going to see right now is an end summary and me revealing which camera was which. Okay, summary then. Straight up, camera A was the Hero 9. Yes, the Hero 9. And I know there's going to be a ton of people sitting there going, no, it wasn't. Because surely camera B was the Hero 9. Because there was a few things about camera B which were better than camera A. Well, no. A was the Hero 9. B was the Hero 8. Also, the audio was done on the Hero 9. This is nothing to do with the audio, this video, really. However, I will say, I did post-process it a bit. I limited it quite a bit and raised its volume up in post. But I have to say, I was very happy with the results. I'm not going to say that it's kind of going to be as good as an external mic or anything. It isn't. But it was very respectable for the microphone inside, a GoPro especially. So yes, if you liked the audio in this video, that's definitely one big positive I could say about the Hero 9. However, if you were watching this video and at any point you thought that you knew which the 9 was, and like genuinely thought you knew because you thought you saw some technical characteristics on the screen which would have led you to have believed that one of these cameras was, well, is supposedly better than the other, you didn't see anything like that. Now, here's the thing. I actually prepared a bunch of bullet points here. Well, I'm not going to do that because the simple bottom line here is the Hero 9, especially for vlogging and day-to-day stuff, is not enough of an upgrade, if any, to the Hero 8. And on top of that, I'd go so far as to say that other than, say, quite specific action or sport stuff, again, the Hero 9 just isn't worth it. And bear in mind a couple of things here is that right now, one of the things that a lot of sports and action people may be looking forward to about the Hero 9 isn't even available, which is that new super ultra wide lens mod thing that GoPro are going to do for it. Also, you will not be able to find a media mod for this right now either. So that's going to affect vloggers. But anyway, that bit aside, let's just quickly get to the crux of like what I've seen in this video. Did anybody else notice that when there was a section where one of the cameras looked like more in focus, like close and sharper, did anybody else notice that was camera B, which was the Hero 8? Because that in fact was the case, especially when I sat them off on the tripod and switched off their stabilizers. As I did that kind of like going in and out of the camera bit, you could definitely see that one of them had better close focus, and it was the 8, right? So if you're going to look at that as a starting point, right, the 8 is better for vlogging, without a doubt. Because if you wanted to get really close to it, like, you know, less than a foot away, the 8 was still in focus. This 9 was dropping off. Don't get me wrong, once it got really close, both of them are out of focus. That's definitely going to happen. But the focus for close object stuff is better on the 8. I've just proved it. Also, focus into the distance. And you might have thought, well, hold on, maybe the 9 was going to be better at that. Not really. I would say, I mean, the thing is, looking at stuff far in the distance, it's going to be a lot harder to judge that stuff than stuff that's close to it or close to the lenses. But the stuff that's far away, you know, you're looking at that and for what, well, they basically look the same as far as sharpness is concerned and focus and all the rest of it. So I've got to say right now, the 8 definitely beats it. Now, here's the weirdest thing about that. Some people are going to say, yeah, but you know, it's got sharpening on. Well, they both had the exact same level of sharpening. You've got to remember that every setting that was on the 8 was replicated on the 9. The only differences here were that the 9 was shooting at a higher resolution. So that already supposedly had the upper hand. Now, just a quick one on that as well. When you're shooting 5K on the 9, it is the same bitrate as what 4K is on the 8. So let that just sink in for a moment. GoPro have got a new camera which shoots 5K, but they have not increased the bitrate beyond what their previous camera was doing at 4K. And this camera's bitrate isn't enough at 4K anyway. So the same bitrate is now being used for 5K on this. So The bitrate wasn't good enough on this anyway, and people can see this themselves when they're doing sports and action stuff. They can see breakup in the picture and stuff like that. There's a whole host of other stuff that goes on, I won't get into it. But that same poor bitrate at 4K is now being used for 5K on this. What's that all about? Anyways, also in this video, I was having to upscale the 4K off this to 5K. Now, straight away, although the scaling that I use is good scaling, it's destructive nonetheless. So I've destroyed the picture there to match the size of this one in the timeline for the edit. So straight away, this had an advantage. This was at a disadvantage for that. Now, unless you were watching it at 4K, or if you were lucky enough to watch it 5K native, you may not have noticed a lot of this stuff. Or indeed, if you were watching it small on a phone, maybe it'd all look pretty much the same. Nonetheless, those differences are there. Also, as well, some people might go, yeah, but Dave, you know, you're in GoPro Color, what do you, you know, no, sod that. GoPro Color is exactly what most people shoot in. I shot with these exactly the same as the vast majority of YouTube videos that have been done so far on the 9. So I'm not going to have anybody give me what for about, yeah, you know, but it was auto white balance, it was auto this, it was auto exposure. Well, some of the biggest videos at the moment about the 9, that's how they've been shot. It just so happens that they get shot in like places with like nicer surroundings, nicer weather, and people get suckered by that stuff. Unfortunately, when you put the 9 in a real scenario with the 8 and you ask it to do the exact same thing, it doesn't make much difference, if any, and the 8 actually ends up being better. Now, the thing is, I was going to rabbit on about a ton of stuff. I did have bullet points here to try and keep me in, you know, keep me in check so I didn't go all wild at the end. But the bottom line is this, the update from the 8 to the 9 isn't worth it for vloggers. Now, there's a couple of other points as well that you have to remember. Right now, you cannot buy the media mod for the 9. It's impossible to get your hands on, right? Also right now, and this is even worse, and I will be doing a separate video, it might already have gone up, but definitely look out for it. You can't put the original 3.5mm mic adapter on the Hero 9. So right now, somebody goes out and buys a Hero 9, right, aside from the fact that it's not as good as the 8 for vlogging, I've just proved it. What you can't do is even plug a microphone into it. So even if you've got an old 3.5mm mic adapter, one of the GoPro ones, you can't use it on it. On top of that, you're not going to find a media mod. However, if you go and buy an 8 now, you will immediately find there's media mods all over the place for this, and it will work immediately with an old 3.5mm mic adapter. So from a vlogger's point of view, you'd have to be absolutely mad to go and buy one of these thinking you're going to vlog with it, because you're not. Unless you can find the media mod, you're screwed. You're not vlogging on this. That's the reason why this also is going to be a better option for vlogging, because at least now you can get the media mod for it, and it's also compatible with the old mic adapter. Now, the thing to do with the exposure and stuff, you could see that they were both blowing out pretty much in the same way and all the rest of it. So yeah, you know, that just shows you that you're not really gaining anything with this, because this was doing the same thing anyway. On top of that, that kind of like, you know, moving around that I was doing, which was very typical for like just normal stuff, the stabilizing on them, you definitely couldn't see that that was supposedly better than that. Now, don't get me wrong, in its higher modes, this does have an advantage, but we weren't in those higher modes. We weren't testing for that. That's more to do with like action and sport. But for just regular day-to-day stuff, no. No difference whatsoever. Field of view is thereabouts exactly the same. Geometry in linear mode, slightly different. That's all I can say, just slightly different. I think the 8 might have made me look like I was a bit thinner than what I am, to be honest. So maybe the 8 a bit more flattering. The 9 made me look, I don't know if I could say more accurate, but it definitely was a bit rounder. Although the geometry, depending upon where it was in the frame, was altering ever so slightly between the two. I wouldn't say that the geometry is a sticking point. It just is what it is. Okay, so with those points gone over there, if you can't see that the 8 edged out the 9 in this video, which was very specifically to do with vlogging and such, if you can't see that the 8 did edge it out, then no one's going to convince you otherwise. You definitely need to go and waste your money on an iron and then go chasing after medium odds for it. However, if you've already got an 8, seriously, you've got the better camera for vlogging already. Don't start worrying about it. Also, if you're on a 5, 6 or a 7 and you want to do an upgrade, I would say look at the 8. Don't really look at that if what you're doing is the vloggy thing. Action stuff, a bit different, but right now, this can't even fulfill the action role properly because the lens thing for it isn't even available. Anyways, what have we got here? Oh, I'm running out of time here. I think I've said what I've had to say. I'd be very, very interested to hear what other people have got to say all about this in the comments below. So as ever, if you want to see all of my GoPro videos, go to www.gopro9.com. That's where you'll see all my videos to do with GoPros. And also there'll be links in the descriptions to this video or indeed any other video that I do with GoPros, which will link you to all the GoPro stuff that I use for me rigs and all that kind of thing. And if you got to the end of this video, then you deserve a medal. No, seriously, thank you very much if you've got to the end of this, or indeed thank you very much for watching any part of this video, and hopefully you've enjoyed it. And if you have, please consider giving me video a thumbs up, subscribe to me channel, all that funky stuff. Anyways, I'm David Harry. Thank you very much for watching this video. Take care and goodbye now.